This is Steve Fowkes providing the voiceover for this presentation. The following slides will explain the simple principles that underlie our vector-directional polymers and show how complex nanostructures can be synthesized on a self-assembly basis. We believe this revolutionary capability will become the core technology that bootstraps bottom-up manufacturing into a practical industrial process. The only explicit chemistry involved in this presentation will be at the beginning to demonstrate the accuracy and validity of the tile schematic. From then on, the developing explanations will rely upon tiles to illustrate all the capabilities of vector-directional polymers. Any discussion of the unique capabilities of NSC's nanopolymers should begin with a side-by-side comparison with regular polymers. Whereas regular polymers use two bonding features to make polymer linkages, NSC's polymers use four bonding features, two of which form a regular linkage, and the other two of which stabilize the linkage in its thermodynamically favored conformation. The any-which-way bonding of regular polymers is overridden by the extra bonding features to create one-way-only bonding in NSC polymers. In other words, the freely rotating bonds, infinite postures, and limp backbones of regular polymers are transformed into restricted rotation bonds, single conformation polymers with vector-directional backbones. Bottom line, the conformational chaos fundamental to regular polymers is replaced with inherent nanostructure in NSC polymers. The specific nanostructure is 100% derived from the choice of monomers used. This slide shows four straight monomers. On the left are visual schematics of the monomers, displayed as tiles with notches and prongs, with the actual chemical structural diagrams on the right. The structures are arbitrarily labeled as male and female to make the concept of monomer pairing intuitively obvious. The primary bonding features are illustrated as large notches and prongs, and the secondary bonding features as small notches and prongs. The large primary bonding features react with each other, and then the small secondary bonding features react. This tile-based graphic analogy is especially accurate because like primary features do not react with each other, and primary and secondary features also do not react with each other. The graphic analogy is also accurate in that there are two kinds of straight monomers of each sex. Furthermore, the secondary bonding features not only stabilize the correct fit, they destabilize the wrong fit. The secondary bonding features provide a significant thermodynamic influence that is the basis for the one-way-only bonding of NSC polymers, and also the basis for nanostructural self-assembly, otherwise known as bottom-up manufacturing. There are 16 possible monomers among the single-ring monomers. They are based on the hexagonal geometry of the core benzene or heterocyclic ring system. The relative orientation of the primary groups on the ring provides side vectors of approximately 0, 60, or 120 degrees, and the positioning of the secondary groups makes the vector positive or negative. Before we advance to the next slide, there are two additional points to make. First, the inverted monomers in the top and bottom rows have vectors of indeterminate sign. This is caused by the inversion of the symmetry in the secondary bonding features, which produces an opposite vector quantity depending upon which end of the monomer bonds first. Second, the leftmost and rightmost columns may not be sterically possible due to position conflicts on a single ring. This positional limitation, when it exists, can be overcome by use of multi-ring monomers. Now we will show varieties of nanostructures resulting from monomer pairs, starting with the straight monomers. The male-female-male-female chain assembles into a straight rod. With a substitution of an inverting male monomer, another, different straight rod is assembled. With both inverting monomers, a third straight rod polymer is assembled. Although these do appear to be similar, they are, in fact, nanostructurally quite different from each other. These differences do not exist in standard art rigid rod polymers. The practical use of such differences can be simply illustrated by the attachment of a pendant group to the left side of the male monomer, which we will thematically describe as sticky. With the first rod polymer, the sticky surfaces are all on one side of each strand, so strand pairing results. With the second rod polymer, the sticky surface alternates sides, so extended sheets of parallel strands are formed. With the third rod polymer, the sticky edges are randomly positioned and no specific If we combine a straight male monomer with a curved female monomer, we get a nanolink if the ends happen to meet, or a nanocoil if the ends do not meet. If both monomers are curved in the same direction, we get a nanocoil with a much smaller diameter. The use of the left-turning monomers instead of the right-turning monomers produces a nanotube with the same small diameter, except it is inside out. This offers a simple means of moving pendant groups from the inside to the outside or vice versa, merely by changing the vector sign of another comonomer. If an inverting monomer is combined with a curved monomer, a sinusoidal, or zigzag rod, is created. There are three additional monomer combinations that can produce a sinusoid of equal oscillation and periodicity. If the curved monomer is not as strongly curved, the resulting sinusoidal oscillations are less pronounced. Again, there are three other monomer pairs that can make a similar sinusoid. In addition to the straight and sinusoidal rods and coils shown previously, a host of additional nanostructures are possible. These include geometric variations on coils, with hexagonal, triangular, and polygonal cross-sections, two-dimensional weaves, matrices, and films, and three-dimensional scaffolds, honeycombs, matrices, and meshes. Details of such structures can be provided. Before advancing to derivatives, it is important to mention another entire category of NSC nanostructures: customized shapes derived from heterogeneous monomer sequences. In other words, using more than just two monomers to make a nanostructure. Heterogeneous nanopolymer sequences are exactly analogous to biological peptides and proteins derived from programmed sequences of the 22 naturally occurring amino acids. However, NSC polymers do not necessarily require water for synthesis, solubility, or function, and they have the potential to be 2 to 10 times smaller than biological enzymes of comparable complexity or functionality. Auxiliary nanostructures are possible by simple derivatization of the primary nanostructure. The polymer backbones have a variety of attachment sites for pendant groups with additional functionalities. In addition, the nanostructural precision of the vector-directional polymer backbone can produce both positional precision and orientational precision of the pendant groups. One more nanostructural feature with exceedingly important functional consequences is compartmentalization. The spectrum of nanostructural capabilities offered by NSC polymers is adaptable to a wide range of industry needs and should be an attractive tool to material scientists. Our previous example of monomer stickiness as an organizing influence for turning single polymer strands into strand pairs and sheets is also applicable to organizing individual nanocoils into bundles. Here, a stickiness bonding group on the straight male monomer causes multiple nanotubes to form a close-packed hexarray. The pendant groups on NSC monomers can end up on the inside or outside surface of a nanocoil. The stickiness pendant group could be considered feature number one, with a second exterior feature located on the curved female monomer. On the inside surface, Feature number 3 could be located on the straight male monomer, and feature 4 could be located on the curved female monomer. This provides up to 4 possible pendant entities and 4 different chemical features that can be automatically incorporated into a nanotube made from just 2 monomers. In reality, backbone curvature may occupy one of the interior sites and create an additional exterior site, and multiple ring monomers may provide even greater numbers of interior and exterior sites. But the 4 functionality generalization still has conceptual value for understanding the capabilities of our nanostructural self-assembly system. Since feature number 1 is devoted to nanotube bundling, there are 3 additional functionalities that can serve additional purposes. For a photovoltaic system, interior feature number 4 could be a redox active doping agent. Feature number 3 could be a chromophore, dedicated to absorbing photons, and exterior feature number 2 could be dedicated to forming an electron conduction pathway. With the NSC polymer system, polyfunctionality can be built into complex nanostructures at the monomer level. Thank you for viewing our presentation. We welcome further inquiries at these addresses and phone numbers.